Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest will be fought in the Super Fight Series under 64 kilogram category and is sponsored by Find the Fitness. Please welcome the first fighter making her way to the blue corner, Elliott, the Killer Hallworth.
To the desk.
10 wins and 10 losses. He represents the fighting
team. I can't hear you.
He is Elliott.
Okay. Yeah, I'm on the talk back now. I was going to ask whether we could not.
And standing across
you're not
the
hearing me.
Red corner, this fighter weighing at 64.9 kilograms has a record of 10 wins, 5 losses, and 1 draw.
Can you hear me
he
now? How's this?
He represents the KO team. From Portugal, Fabio Veiga.
Can you guys see me now on this one? Can you hear me or not? Okay. Can we get off in hearing all the replay stuff?
Three-minute rounds in this super fight. Elliott Hallworth from the Fighting Tigers, Andy Chambers, our old friend, against Fabio Veiga from KO Team Portugal, matched at 64K here. And Chris, we've seen young Elliott Hallworth before, very competent young man, giving away experience tonight, but always comes to fight.
Elliott Hallworth is that always aggressive, always...
varied striker. He's got really solid bread and butter combinations, comes from a strong Muay Thai background. The clue, of course, the flag on the back of his shorts. That being said, this is a really intriguing international matchup. The KO crew from Portugal have brought over some really strong fighters. I know that Fabio Veiga has a little bit of a boxing background as well, so let's see how that translates to K1 rules here tonight.
Well, as you said that, Chris, he caught Elliott sweetly on the way in as Elliott came in. But as we said, one of the things we love about Elliott, you look at his record, 10 wins, 10 losses. Oh, the knee, the knee! Chris Batchelor straight in there as the knee landed, Chris.
Beautiful alternating hooks there. We talked about the boxing skills of Veiga. He followed up with that knee to the midsection, and we've got a count here early in the first.
And Chris, that is perfect timing on that count. I was just about to say that with Elliott, the 10-10 record reflects the fact that he always comes forward to finish you, but runs the risk of being finished. He's such an exciting fighter in that style.
Yeah, he's got to get back to basics here. He does not want to allow Veiga to come in and use those power punches. Veiga actually led with hooks, so he wasn't even leading off the jab when he rocked Hallworth there. Here we go again, lightning fast hands there from Veiga. Hallworth is a risk taker, and he's paying here, Malcolm, as Veiga continues to work the body.
And he works the body with those knees that come up like a jab, Chris. He just brings the knee forward without... Oh, and the right hand's rocked him as well here.
Beautiful pull counter there from Veiga. Threw a punch, leaned back, loaded up on the right hand. Hallworth looked to attack, reached out with his left, and was susceptible to that right coming down.
The problem for Hallworth is not just the fist, it's the knees, and you can hear the Portuguese corner saying use it, because Veiga, as you so rightly said, so good with his hands, but he brings the knee up frighteningly as well. But look at Hallworth. This is what he's about, Chris. This is why he's exciting. This is why his record stands as it does.
I'd like to see Hallworth stick and move. He's got a good, strong kicking game. He's got solid footwork. He needs to be more of an elusive target. A stationary target could be dangerous here.
I think you're dead right. And I mean, with Vega's accuracy and not knowing whether it's the chopping right hand or the big knees. But Veiga, he needs to tighten up again. He's such a good boxer. He's now getting carried away a little bit. And there again, that left and then the knee is the key. Elliott's taking a lot of punishment here, Chris.
Hallworth has got to watch out for that right. When he reaches out with the jab, Vega's timing him with the right. He's slipping to the inside, and he's coming over the top of the guard. Great first round from both guys, but that is a huge first round for Veiga.
Rightly so, and the problem for Elliott was the knee was the dangerous third tool in those combinations. He'd throw the left, he'd throw the right hand, but equally, he could throw the knee with aplomb and accuracy. And although it was the knee that dropped him, the setups were from the punches. And again, you see, Elliott is a dangerous young man. He likes to come forward 10 and 10, but look at the counter punching there of Veiga.
You can see Veiga looking for that right. Hallworth did well to out, sort of evade him there. 1-2 though, the fast hands, and then Veiga jumps in for the knee. It's a crazy mix, isn't it, Malcolm? In K1, we often see different striking styles, guys who have different paces. Vega's been using boxing, and then kind of the knees that you often see from like a Muay Thai, Muay Thai style fighter. It's crazy.
This is what I said to you, Chris. This is what the game is for Hallworth. He's not sure which, because he used the setup so well. The punch, the setup for the knee, or vice versa. And they're both as dangerous. And they are both fight stoppers. But Elliott will still come forward. That's his game. That's the way he fights. That's why he's exciting.
Hallworth is also noticeably the bigger fighter. He cuts more weight. He needs to continue to use intelligent pressure here. I think that Hallworth wants to try to draw Veiga into a firefight, but I'm not sure that's the wisest strategy given what happened in the last frame.
The other thing that he's got to remember as well is Veiga throws that knee like a jab. He just brings it straight up, no back lift. He brings it in just like that and like the right hand as well. He's so alert and so quick.
Sometimes when Hallworth squares up, he'll be more open to that body shot. That's when Veiga wants to time it. This is good for Hallworth. He's got to use those kicks. He's got really solid kicks. Attack the legs of Veiga. Double jab. Throw multiple punch combinations. Stick and move. Come in, throw those combinations, and then retreat, getting away from those dangerous overhand shots, that right hand from Veiga, or, of course, the knee.
I think, Chris, the other point you made is also telling. He's got to make that size count. He's a powerful young man. So when he does get in, make that work count, then get back out. As you said, throw the heavy shots. He's starting to do that with the hooks.
Oh, that hurt him again, Malcolm. That liver shot. Veiga has ridiculous power with those knees. Picture perfect stuff. Throttles the hips forward, comes up on the ball of his foot. And he's so accurate as well. I mean, he's been able to find Hallworth more often than not with those shots. He's going to work the liver again. Switch kick now. Open stance. Right foot forward. Tons of power on that back leg when he stands with right foot forward. Good job from Hallworth catching that lazy stance swap and kicking the leg. Double time here for Hallworth.
That's what he's got to do more of, Chris. Against such a dangerous man, he must start targeting that base and those legs and make Veiga start thinking about his defense here. That one way of getting your own offense is to make Veiga start thinking and starting having to check like that. When he's coming forward in full flow like this is when he's most dangerous.
And so the clock is running here. Hallworth needs to try and steal this round because he clearly lost the first with that count.
You saw again, he targeted the lead leg of Veiga. It's the right tactic. Make him think, try and stop him in his tracks, because when the young man is in flow, he's very dangerous indeed. There, keep him there. Have you noticed again, that simple act has stopped so many combinations coming through.
Absolutely, it's what we thought about from the beginning. He needs to use those basic, real fundamental, nothing fancy. Fundamental attacks, basics win fights.
That's right, Chris, and again, when you tie up Veiga, once you can get beyond that knee, he's got his own chances here. I still don't think he's done enough to win the round, but I think we've seen enough from Hallworth in the second to realize he's working his way around Vega's strategy now. Oh, I
Veiga
say that.
Freeze and jumps up there for a double knee. Hallworth backing off. This is really, really close to a count. Saved by the bell.
Chris, just as I said, he was beginning to figure Veiga out. Those knees again, the devastating knees of Fabio Veiga came into play right at the end of the round. Incredible stuff from the young Portuguese fighter.
That's the thing. Once Veiga sees that you are hurt, he jumps all over you. But it was a better job from Hallworth of controlling the fight more on his terms. Let's take a look back at some of the action here. You see that inside low kick from Hallworth. Nice outside slip, clearing the jab of Veiga. And Malcolm, it was an improvement for the young man from the Fighting Tigers gym.
Most definitely in the second round. And as we said, we stopped the momentum for good periods of it because there's the danger to him, and that's it, the big knee. Up until that point, Elliott done a really good job, but for want of a better term, slowing Veiga down, stopping those combinations. But then right at the end of the round, you saw it again.
And it's not like Elliott Hallworth had a really open guard. It's not like he was like super open for that shot, but Veiga was able to sneak that knee right up between the elbows. That's a knockout shot if it lands.
Well, we're in the third and final round, and I honestly agree, believe now, that with the two rounds down, Elliott, this is the right tactic for him. This is how he fights, but again, got caught with a sweet right hand.
Huge flurry here from Veiga, and it's another count.
The knee again, and do you know what? His eyes, look at his eyes, Chris. The towel's in. Good call from Andy Chambers. Chris was looking at his eyes there. He was rocking. He was like a man on board a ship there. Good call from Andy Chambers. That's a great coach work right there.
Fabio Veiga stops Elliott Hallworth here. It was a late stoppage here in the third round, but it was a beautiful performance from Fabio Veiga of mixing up the boxing and some seriously stylistic approaches to delivering those knees, Malcolm.
And it was after a good start from Elliott, but it's the accuracy. Look at this, the accuracy. Then there he starts to wobble, and he doesn't stop. He stays like a sailor at the sea after that. I am so impressed with Fabio Veiga. You alluded to the boxing background. We saw that. But it's the dexterity of his knees as well, Chris.
I love it because in K1, you often see different approaches to fighting in kickboxing. Some guys bring in more Muay Thai, some Sanshu, Karate, Taekwondo, full contact kickboxing, or a kind of a more hand-centric approach like we saw there from Fabio, mixing in with those wild knees. Incredible stuff. Grant Waterman here is our master of ceremonies. He will make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 22 seconds of the third round, we have a winner. By way of TKO, Fabio Veiga!
guys hear me if I talk like this? Can you guys hear me if I talk like this?